exploring to me is something about looking at the history of the place. It's looking past the four walls, the rotting walls, the broken floorboards. It's looking past that and looking at what it was. And it's best when there's stuff left from the past, so little artifacts and stuff like that. So it's sort of about looking at the history and documenting it for me. It's tough to find the next place to explore because it's something that not many people know about. At the end of the day, it's an abandoned building, so not many people know about it. But mostly through word of mouth, friends that I've made through doing it, they come to me and they say, okay, we just checked out this place, so you should go and have a look before it gets ruined or something like that. So I'll head there and film it, but generally it's through word of mouth. There is websites like forums and little maps and stuff like that, but also checking newspapers as well. That's quite helpful for looking at places that have closed down in the past 10 years or something, and then hopefully getting there before it's demolished or burned to the ground. The general view of urban exploring is very mixed. I feel like it's 50-50. There's people who really look down on it and just see us as trespassing criminals. But there's also a lot of people who really enjoy it and are really interested in what we have to show. Because I was surprised at how many older people enjoy it, because it's something that they've probably seen those places when they were active. And now to see them where it's just crumbling and just seem like it falling apart, a lot of people are interested in it. As far as unwritten rules go, there isn't too many. I think the biggest one is trying not to name places, especially in public, because apparently the wrong people might see it, and then if something happens, then you're to blame for it. But I feel like that's the only rule, especially in Europe sites. If you go to France and go to a big mansion or something, if you then name that, then it's really frowned upon. So yeah, naming places is a big no-no. See the point of vandalizing the buildings. Obviously to the kids who do it, it's a bit of fun, it's a laugh, but to explorers it's pointless. It sort of ruins it for us a bit. But in a way we kind of need them to make the access, because we don't break into places, so without them we couldn't get in. But then there's also the problem where they trash it, so it's sort of like a 50-50% thing. But yeah, I don't really see the point of it. I feel like one of the biggest risks is obviously the condition of the building. We've been walking around places before and my friend's foot went through the floor and there's stuff like that. I went to Denby Asylum in Wales and I was on my own there. There was nobody around for miles and that place was a crumbling wreck. And there was no phone signal or anything. So if something did happen, then who knows what would have happened. But I feel like you've got to just be careful where you tread and just don't rush it. And, you know, if you are going to do it, then just take your time.